Good morning, everyone. Wayne Hathaway here with you with Some Good Seeds in the Denver, Colorado area as we're on our way home from this trip that we've been taking. And glad to be with you today and so thankful for each and every one of you who takes the time to spend this little devotion time with me. I'm so thankful for God's Word and for the inspiration and the help and the encouragement that we receive from it. And today is no different. The reading that was done here in Colossians chapter 1 today, verses 13 and 14, it's particularly inspirational. I've entitled this little devotion today, Conveyed, because the word that is used in this chapter. Our overall reading is from 1 Kings chapter 16 and 2 Chronicles 15 and 16, and then Colossians chapter 1. These verses are just so wonderful. Give a listen to what Paul says here to the Colossians. He has delivered us from the power of darkness and conveyed us into the kingdom of the Son of His love, in whom we have redemption through His blood, the forgiveness of sins. This is just an amazing passage. And again, the title comes from that word that is used by the Apostle Paul here, conveyed. It's an interesting word that really greatly impacts the understanding in this verse. It means something that has been carried or brought from one place to another. Hence, there is a marginal reading that says transferred. There is, first of all, the deliverance that comes from the power of darkness, which is in and of itself glorious beyond description, because we've been moved. It's what Paul spoke of in Romans 6 when he says we have been delivered from the penalty, the power. And praise God, one day soon, I believe, we're going to all be delivered from the presence of sin. And what a glorious day that's going to be. There's something additional about what he says here about deliverance that I think is really important and really encouraging to us today. He describes our former position as being under the power of darkness. Interesting that in Ephesians chapter 5, he says that we walked in darkness, but now we are children of light. The contrast here is just, well, dark and light. I mean, in the dark, but now in the light. Just an amazing, all the while when we were walking in the darkness, we thought we were okay. Just needed a little tweak here and there and life would be great. But all it was darkness, and we didn't even know it, didn't even realize it. But now we have been conveyed into the light. It's more than that. We have been transferred into the kingdom of the Son of His love. We've been moved. We have a new address. Praise the Lord. We did not move ourselves, but we have been moved. We have been redeemed, bought back, and that's the qualifier. Jesus is the one who has made that all possible. There's no hint of anything whatsoever that has been done by us. As Paul says in Ephesians 2, by grace we have been saved, not of works. It's the gift of God. So that we don't boast about it as though we did something in and of ourselves. It's all the work of the Spirit of God. It was a work that He did, made possible by the shedding of His blood. And what does that redemption consist of? Forgiveness of sins, for sure. But in general, deliverance from one place, transferred from one place to another place. And one day, as Paul tells us throughout his epistles, as the Word of God tells us throughout all of Scripture, we have a hope in heaven. And that is that realization gives us strength for today. It helps us in being victorious and walking in victory over sin. As 1 John says, if we have that hope in us, we cleanse ourselves. He who has this hope cleanses himself. It's just so important that we see and remind ourselves on a regular basis, daily, of the grace that has been extended to us so that we have been transferred from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of the Son of His love. Oh, praise the Lord, conveyed, moved from one place to another. And that's our status today. That's the place that we are because of all that Jesus has done for us. Praise the Lord. I pray that's an encouragement to you today that helps you through the day that you're going through the trials and the tests that you're going to face. May the Lord richly bless you in that. And again, if it does, share it, like it, subscribe, do all those things so that other people can share in the blessing of that. And I want to encourage you to be in the Word on a daily basis. These are things that you can, little seeds that you can plant in your own heart and make a good planting, so that when the need arises, the Word of God is there to inspire you and to encourage you. And it will be a lamp to your feet, as David says, and a lamp to your feet and a light to your pathway. Oh, friends, stay in the Word, be in the Word, and it will bless you and encourage you. May the Lord richly bless you today, I pray. Amen.